Let's walk through an entire byte cycle. So here's our data line from our demodulator in the last video. It stays high when we're in between bytes. As soon as the start bit arrives, our signal transitions to low. Our start bit detector picks up the falling edge and sends out a pulse. That pulse goes down to the inverter where the pulse is inverted. The inverted pulse is sent to the shift registers to clear any data currently stored on them. The inverted pulse is also sent to the SR latch, starting our clock. But then there's this little hacky thing I mentioned where I invert the pulse again, essentially getting us the original but stronger signal back. This signal gets sent down to the counter reset pin, ensuring we always start our count at zero. I had some issues with the counter not resetting from the original pulse signal, but sending it through the inverter twice seemed to give the counter what it needed, so I left it at that. So back up here, the SR latch signal sets the SR latch. This activates the start bit detection inhibitor, preventing more start bits, and it also causes the reset pin of the 555 to go high, which starts our clock. The clock signal is this yellow line coming from the 555. It's fed to the counter, as well as to the SR shifty shift registers. By the time the first bit is ready on the serial line, we get our first pulse of the clock, which signals the counter to count and the shifties to latch the current bit. Then, some time has passed and our next bit is ready. We get our next clock pulse, which again triggers the shift registers and the counter. This happens over and over and over again until we get to our last stop bit. On the last bit, the 10 pin goes from low to high, and we send that to our inverter to reverse it, making it a high to low, or to a falling edge, and that gets sent to our falling edge detector, which creates a nice short pulse. We send that to the inverter, which again inverts the pulse and sends that to the SR latch. The SR latch is reset by this, and this causes the reset of the 555 to go low, which stops the clock. It also disables our start bit inhibitor to ensure that we're ready to detect the next start bit, which is about to come really soon. What we now have on our shift register LEDs is the byte that came in from our demodulator, ready to be sent on to our computer. Well, hello there, lovely. So with all this in place now, we should be ready to send an entire data stream through our circuit to decode some stuff. So to decode this stuff, I'm going to connect my Arduino up to the outputs of the shift register, and then I'm going to use the SR latch to tell the Arduino when the data is ready to be read. So let's run a Kansas City standard WAV file, encoded with PyKCS, through the circuit and let's see what we get. Well, would you look at that? I love this stuff. That's beautiful.